Barb and our two dogs, Lucy and Hattie, live on a wooded acre plot just west of Jefferson City, Missouri. Gravel road, septic tank, propane. We love it. Been here for, 28 years or something like that. Our house and yard is in one corner of the plot at the end of a cul-de-sac. Most of our 3 acres of land goes down a hill, and it is covered in scrub cedar. Some hardwood, but a lot of cedar. It's never been thinned out, never cleared, just woods. I recently started cutting some of the cedar, but quickly decided that we needed some professional advice, so we had a professional forester come out and take a look and offer some suggestions. He said that if we selectively cut some, the remaining trees would be healthier, and explained that we needed to think of our woods as an entire system rather than just individual trees. So one day in November, he came out with his chainsaw and he dropped 40 or 50 trees in a matter of hours. The plan was just to leave them as they fell and let nature do the rest. And I thought I was okay with that, but once I saw it, it was just a little more chaos than I could bear. A lot of trees stacked on top of other trees. Some were leaning up against standing trees. It just looked a little too much like a tornado had come through for me. So I fired up my little chainsaw and started cleaning things up. So what I've been doing is trimming the limbs. Then once the trunk is on the ground, I cut it up into lengths that are small enough for me to move and stack. And all of this is generating some really massive brush piles and many, many, many stacks of logs. Now, I've been assured by numerous people that the brush could be safely burned, but I don't want to do that. I've decided to leave the brush piles for the squirrels and the chipmunks and the birds and all the other wildlife, and they're already moving in. As for the stacks of wood, we've had some interest from people who burn wood for heat, and we may eventually just let them haul that off and give it to them. We have a fireplace, but it's not for heating purposes. It's just for fun. I will say I have found the chainsaw work and the brush hauling, both which are physically very demanding, but the work instills an almost zen-like state. 2 or 3 hours go by in just seconds. So, depending on the weather, I probably have another 4 to 6 weeks of work, and I'll post more video when I'm done.